The struct keyword in C# is used to create value types. A struct is similar to a class in that it represents a structure with mainly field and method members. However, a struct is a value type, whereas a class is a reference type. Therefore, a struct variable directly stores the data of the struct, while a class variable only stores a reference to an object allocated in the memory. Structs share most of the same syntax as classes. For example, the struct here is named point and consists of two public fields. Given this struct definition, a variable of the point type can be initialized in the familiar way, using the new operator. When creating a struct variable in this way, the default constructor will be called, which sets the fields to their default values. Unlike classes, structs can also be instantiated without using the new operator. The fields will then remain unassigned. However, just as when attempting to use a local uninitialized variable, the compiler will not allow the fields to be read until they have been initialized. Structs can contain the same members that classes can, except that they cannot contain destructors or parameterless constructors. The parameterless constructor is automatically provided and cannot be user-defined. However, a struct may declare constructors that have parameters. The compiler will then enforce that all struct fields are assigned in the constructors, so as to avoid problems associated with unassigned variables. Given this definition, the following statements will both create a point with the fields initialized to zero. Fields within a struct cannot be given initial values, unless they are declared as const or static. Structs cannot inherit from another struct or class, and they cannot be a base class. This also means that struct members cannot be declared as protected or protected internal, and that struct methods cannot be marked as virtual. Structs implicitly inherit from system value type, which in turn inherits from system object. Although structs do not support user-defined inheritance, they can implement interfaces in the same way as classes. The struct type is typically used to represent lightweight classes that encapsulate small groups of related variables. The primary reason for using a struct instead of a class is to get value type semantics. For example, the simple types are in fact all struct types. For these types, it is more natural that assignment copies the value rather than the reference. Structs can also be useful for performance reasons. A struct is more efficient than a class in terms of memory. It not only takes up less memory than a class, but it also does not need memory to be allocated for it as required by reference type objects. Furthermore, a class requires two memory spaces, one for the variable and one for the object, whereas a struct only needs one. This can make a significant difference for a program that operates on a great number of data structures. Bear in mind that assignment and value parameter passing are typically more expensive with structs than with reference types, because the entire struct needs to be copied for such operations.